I still think it sounds better as Dragon Ball Fighter Z. The problem with Dragon Ball Fighters is that phonetically it makes it seem like that awfully boring Dragon Ball series where Goku uses a stick to fight some robots or something. You've got to have the Z in there to distinguish this game has interesting characters in it, like Vegeta. But really, they should just have called it Dragon Brawl Z. And I wish I could say I come up with that, but credit goes to Matt here. Yeah, that's right, it's a fighting game, and you know, it's pretty funny really. Dragon Ball Z games basically all started off as fighting games. The majority of them were straight arcade fighters like Budokai, and people were getting tired of that format. Dragon Ball Z is more than just fighting, so companies started doing things like Sagas and Xenoverse to add some RPG flavor to it, and now we've come full circle and are back straight to fighting games. But there are definitely things that Fighters does to stand out from the crowd. For a start, there is a full story mode, and it's pretty extensive. It tells an original story, or as original as a Dragon Ball storyline could be, and it's really lengthy. You'll fight your way through boss battles, rescue missions, and battle tutorials that are all placed on a kind of grid-like map. Beat the boss, and you'll progress the story. All the gameplay is done through arcade fighting, so the story all comes from brilliantly animated cutscenes. Everything is fully voiced, and all the current Dragon Ball voice actors reprise their roles, whether you play in Japanese or English. It is all really well done, the writing captures the spirit of Dragon Ball Z, and all the voice actors sound just as natural as if they were recording an episode of the anime. Perhaps the coolest thing about the story mode is that there are Easter eggs and hidden scenes everywhere. Some cutscenes only play if you have certain combinations of characters in your team, while other cutscenes are unlocked as you increase the character's level. The other thing Dragon Ball Fighters does that makes it stand out is looking and feeling exactly like Dragon Ball Z. It is so close to watching the anime, and it's just really awesome. Some of the moves are near frame for frame identical to what you saw as a kid in the 90s. Now, I am not a fighting game expert. I don't play that many fighting games, I don't know about netcode, and I'm not really very good at any fighter, so if you're watching this review for a detailed analysis of the mechanics, you're in the wrong place. But what I can tell you is what it's like from a non-fighting game professional's perspective. And what is important is that it's fun. There is a good learning curve that doesn't just ramp up to 11 out of nowhere. The tutorials are straightforward and paced really well, especially if you experience them all in the story mode. There is the option to do all of the tutorials one after the other in a special training mode as well, which is good if you just need a quick crash course. There are also combo challenges for every single character in the training mode, which is a neat way of learning both simple and advanced combos you can pull off. It's one of the only fighting games I've played that I can remember that has such an extensive training mode. It really goes out of its way to teach you everything you need to know and everything you could possibly want to know. And really, even I know that this game is not going to take the fighting game esports scene by storm. It is obviously not meant for that level of play. It is meant for your average gamer and even first timers. There is plenty to learn and plenty of advanced techniques to practice though, and at the risk of sounding cliche, it is the epitome of easy to pick up and hard to master. Oh yes, the hot topic in gaming right now, loot boxes. Well, when I first started playing, I noticed the capsule vendor, and then I noticed that capsules give randomized rewards, and then I noticed something called Premium Z coins, and then I noticed a button in that vendor that says go to the PlayStation Store, and after noticing all that, I was really worried, but thankfully the Premium Z coins are just given to you if you get a duplicate in the normal capsules, and when you have enough Z coins, you can directly buy stuff you want rather than have it be a gamble. The devs confirmed that the capsules or Z coins would not be purchasable with real money, which is a good thing. And as far as the loot boxes go, they're even more optional than any game that claims to have only cosmetic items in them. The only things in these capsules, as far as I can tell, are little avatars that are only used in the main menu overworld area, as well as Z stamps, which are also only used in that area, and then a few ways to customize your player card. No character progression or even in-game cosmetics are hidden inside loot boxes. You can go straight into a battle with any of the characters and use any color option on them. The capsules appear to be nothing more than an attempt at giving the player something to do while waiting for matches. And just one quick note, I said that you can use any of the characters right off the bat, which is true in the sense that the characters don't come from capsules, but you do need to unlock Android 21 via the story mode, and Super Saiyan God, Super Saiyan Goku, and Vegeta are unlocked through the arcade mode if you didn't pre-order. I think the most important thing about Dragon Ball FighterZ is that it's fun. It's as simple as that. It isn't prohibitively complex, it has excellent presentation, and fans of Dragon Ball will absolutely love all the little things they thought of. It is definitely the best Dragon Ball fighting game we've ever had, and quite possibly the best Dragon Ball game bar none. Move over Mario Kart, 90s kids just got a new party game of choice. And speaking of choices, you could choose between the like or dislike buttons below the video. Also, head down to the comments and tell me who your favorite Dragon Ball character is. I'll respect your opinion, even if you pick trash like Goku. And if you're feeling extra generous, you could check out my Amazon and Patreon links to help support the channel. Have a good day, or night, and I'll see you all soon.